everybody wants happiness, right? Nobody likes unhappiness. So everybody is in search of happiness. You came from right way from Madras to here. Why? For what? To achieve happiness. See, in India you find happiness is not enough one. I will get here. Happiness in the form of name, fame, money, comforts and everything. See? But try to understand, what about these happiness? Are they permanent or temporary? Because in this world, everything is temporary. This body is also temporary. Money is also temporary. Sometimes money comes or it may go. Nobody knows if stocks, in stocks, you think that I can add more in stock. You invest and sometimes you lose, you may lose. So when you lose, that time you realize, oh, this is all temporary. This is not permanent happiness. So everybody wants happiness, but still the search of happiness has never ended. You are in search all the time. You are after it. See, right from childhood till that, everybody is in search of happiness. It's a small child. The object of happiness always changes. And so our search is always there. Because the always object changes, you have to find out another object for to achieve happiness. For example, if the child is small, then the object is small, toys and something, these are the objects, or some milk or some food. That is the only thing which the child gets, happiness. Child doesn't know, small child, what is the clothes or what is the money and I will get happiness from this and that. No. His limitation, his understanding of achieving happiness is very limited. Food, milk and small toys, that's it. And as age advances, the belief of objects to achieve happiness changes. Bigger toys, bat and ball, if girls are there, dolls and everything, these are objects for achieving happiness. And then still other, as age advances, then bat and baseball and this and that. See, the happiness of, definition of happiness and object also changes. And after young age, the teenager will say, okay, I am not satisfied with this doll. I want living doll now. So object also changes. So try to find some girlfriend or boyfriend, some education, starting, why education? Because, see, belief is that if I get more education, then good job and good money and good house and cars and good wife and so I will be happy. So for that, he start educating. So same, one by one, then he wants some children, then small apartment, this big apartment, then big house and new cars and this all the time. See, there is no end of happiness. As because of why this is and happiness ends, because the object is always temporary. The object from which you are trying to achieve happiness, that object is temporary and you want permanent happiness. So there is this discrepancy there. So as soon as the object gets destroyed or finishes, then you find unhappiness. The same object, if goes away or get destructed, then you start experiencing unhappiness. So again, you start finding the object from which you achieve happiness. The cycle goes on and goes on. Since infinite life, there is no permanent happiness is achieved. So this search of happiness is always there, always there, always there. Now, how can you get the solution of it? So, if you find object which is permanent, and happiness from that permanent object, if you achieve, then there will be end of all your search for happiness. And that object, try to find out in this world which thing is permanent or eternal. Try to find out. Body finishes one day. House, we don't know, the house will remain there and we will go away, pass away. Right? Nobody knows. Everything is temporary. Nothing is eternal. So if this body is also temporary, but your true self is permanent. Your true self is there all the time, witnessing everything right from your childhood till the death. You are there, constant. No change in that. Changes are always external part. That your relative self, not in real self. So you have to achieve the real happiness, then you have to realize your true self. In reality, who am I? That I is always there. And that I is eternal element. Our all ancient realized person, has already said about all true self. And in present also, those who have realized the true self, they say this part is nothing but your own Atma. We call it Atma or Soul. And that thing is true self. This is Atma is a name given to just understand what is true. But real thing is your true self. I, real I.